Hi everyone. If you don't know me, my name is Miss Linnea or Miss L. First, before we get started, I wanted to show you the props that I'll be using today in case you wanted to grab some things around the house as well. So first of all, if you have ballet shoes, if you have tap shoes, make sure those are close by. You'll want your ballet shoes on first. We'll put the tap shoes on second. If you don't have ballet shoes, you can be in bare feet, you can be in socks, whatever is best for your floor. Instead of tap shoes, if you don't have tap shoes at home, you can wear sneakers, or you, as Mr. David has said, you could tape little quarters to the bottom of your feet, and that will add some sound. But bare feet is probably not good for tap, so make sure you have some sort of hard shoe for when you dig your heel and tap your toe and things like that. Also, I will be something you can jump over. So nothing too big, but something around the room that you might want to be able to jump over. That's a good prop. I'm also going to be using a wand. So grab something that you might have that could use, that could work as a wand, including maybe like a Barbie doll or something like that, or just something that you can hold. For freeze dance, I'm going to be using a pom-pom. So if you have anything around the house that might work as a pom-pom or just something to hold or shake or move, we'll be using all of those props today. Okay, let's get started. Oh. Also, when we dance under the stars, if you have a flashlight, grab a flashlight. It could be fun. You'll be able to turn all of your lights off in the living room or wherever you are and maybe use a flashlight. You don't want it to be too dark. You can also just leave a crack of light from coming from a window, whatever you prefer for under the stars. Okay, let's get started. So we're gonna start on the floor, doing a little stretch on the floor. So why don't you all take a seat wherever you are, facing the camera so you can see me, and we're gonna start crisscross applesauce with our legs on the floor. I'm gonna join you in just one moment. We're gonna be using Disney music today. Woo! Yay, Disney. Here we go. Are you all sitting crisscross applesauce on the floor? Good. Here we go. I can't hear you. I'm pretending like I can't. Here we go. Here we go. Crisscross applesauce, sitting up nice and tall. We're going to start by looking up and down. Up and down. Side to side, side to side. Just your neck, just your head. And take your ear to your shoulder, other side. Stretching out different parts of your neck. Good, let's swing our head side to side. Swing, swing, swing. Turn that to a head roll all the way around. Good. One more time. Reverse it other way. Last time, nice and slow. Good. Let's lift those shoulders up. We go up and down. Up and down towards your ears. Two more. Last one. Good. Now roll your shoulders front to back to warm up your chest. Open your chest. Two more. Roll. And roll. Good. We're going to make a big rainbow reaching forward. Boom. Trying to keep your bottom on the floor and just drop your head. Let's walk those hands to the diagonal. You're going to take your nose towards your knee. Keep your bottom on the floor. And other side, walk those hands over to the other diagonal. Let's sit up nice and tall. We're going to take some side bends. Nice and slow. Side bend. Two more. Last one. Good. All right. Let's make a sandwich. So let's pick up one whip, put some peanut butter on it. And pick up your other foot, put some jelly on it. And let's make a sandwich on the count of three. One, two, three, boom. Let's flap those butterfly wings. And let's go really slow. Let's fly really slow. And faster, 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 go, 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 go. And let's take our nose to our toes. Smell the roses by your toes and hold it. And sit up tall. Let's take a boat. Let's go on a boat. We're gonna fly. We're gonna fly side to side. Warming up your hips. Good. All right. And enough with that rocking. We're gonna extend those legs out in front of us. So straighten those legs. Point your toes. Zip your legs together so your legs look like mine. We're gonna point those toes down to the floor. Then flex up to the ceiling. Again. Point. Hold it. Good night, toes. Good morning, toes. Now we switch. 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 Okay, warming up your ankles and your toes. Two more. You can put your hands on the floor if you like. You're going to roll those toes out. Parents, I hope you're trying this too. Roll those toes out. One more. Now let's go the other direction. Our toes go in. And in, two more, nice and slow. Ankle rolls, last time. Good, point your toes, we'll make a big rainbow. Reach forward one more time. You reach as far forward as you can. If you can't touch your toes, that is fine. You go as far as you can, and you drop your head. Anybody recognize this song, where it's from, what movie? Yeah, it is. Toy Story 1. Toy Story 1. And now we're going to do the same thing but with flexed feet. It might be a little bit easier to touch your toes. Maybe not. That's okay. You just reach forward. Alright, and we are going to open up to our pizza. Open up to your biggest slice of pizza. If we had our choice, we would not want a tiny little slice of pizza, right? We would want a big slice of pizza. So point your toes, and I want you to think of an ingredient that you might want on your pizza. I want you to shout it out now. One ingredient for your pizza. Since I can't hear you, I'm going to make up my own. I'm going to say some pepperoni. So let's put that ingredient all over your pizza. Put it all over your pizza. And now we're going to slice down the middle. Slice it. Boop. All right, we need another ingredient. So I want you to shout out another ingredient that you're thinking of. Since I can't hear you, I'm gonna say cheese. Let's sprinkle some cheese or whatever your ingredient is all over your pizza. We should have done that first, I think. And now we slice down the middle, slice it. Hold it. Good. And we just need one more ingredient for your pizza. What might that be? Maybe your crust. We forgot about the crust, yeah? So let's crunch that crust or whatever your ingredient is, yeah? Put that on your pizza. And now last time, we're gonna slice down the middle and hold it for a moment, okay? Hold it. Now it's important here, good, and come up. It's important that your knees are facing up to the ceiling. Yeah, we don't want our legs turning in towards the floor. So make sure those knees, top of your knees, are facing up to the ceiling. We're gonna take some side bends up and over. Good, hold it. Other side, up and over, make a big rainbow. Keep your bottom on the floor, two more times. Up and over. Last time, up and over. All right, it's time to mix up our pizza. Let's mix it up. Mix it up. And pop in the oven. We're going to count to eight all together to wait for our pizza. Here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Ding! Pick up your pizza and eat it. And you can wipe your hands on your tights, on your leggings, whatever you're wearing right now. Just don't tell your parents. Okay. We're going to come onto our tummies to be little snakes in the grass. Okay, so everybody, come onto your tummies. Make sure you can see me. I'm going to turn the music down just a little bit so you can hear me. Make sure you're on your tummies. Whoop. And we're going to be tiny little snakes in the grass. And we're going to wiggle. Here we go. Oh, wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Oh, wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Oh, wiggle, 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 wiggle. And press up to your forearms, to your elbows. And we're going to look around the safari. Oh, my goodness. I think I see a rhinoceros. Come on down. He could crush us. Let's try again. Here we go. Oh, wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Oh, wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Oh, wiggle, 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 wiggle. And press up onto your hands this time. Nice big cobra stretch. Look all the way around the safari. What do you see? I think I see a giraffe. Oh my goodness, come on down. They could crush us too. Last time, here we go. Oh, wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Oh, wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Oh, wiggle, 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 wiggle. And press all the way up one more time. Big cobra stretch. And look around the safari. Can you bend your snake tail to your snake head? Oh my goodness, I'm so far. Maybe you're closer. Big reach, big reach. And come on down. I think I saw an elephant. That could crush us too. But we made it. We're going to come on up to tabletop position. Why do you think this is called tabletop position? What part looks like a tabletop? If you said your back, you are correct. So we're in tabletop position. We're going to round our spine. Look at your belly button and say, meow. Look up to the ceiling, arch your back, and say moo. And again, we say meow. Look up and say moo. One more time. Here we go. Meow. And last time, moo. Good. And now we're going to wag our puffy dog tail. So wag, wag, wag. And we'll pull our hips back to child's pose. So you want your bottom near your heels and just reach your arms forward. Drop your head down and take some deep breaths here, okay? Just relax your lower back. And slowly start to roll up. You're gonna grow your flowers, okay? So start to grow those flowers. And we're going to poke through the earth. And on the count of three, we stand up, and I want you to show me your flower, okay? Any shape you want. One, two, three. Good. What kind of flower were you today? I want you to tell your parents what kind of flower you were and what color you were. Today, I was a blue violet. A blue violet. Yeah. So, now that you're standing, we're going to get going with our center work. So, you still don't need any props. So last week, if you remember, our word of the week was the five positions of ballet. So I wanted to go over those again with you today in case you missed it. And parents, you can learn as well. So, I want to do the five positions of the legs and the arms, okay? So, we know this is first position with the legs, right? Do you know first position with the arms? If you know it, I want you to do it right now. Let me see if I can see some of you. Do we know first position with those arms? Can you show me? We're gonna take our arms up like you're holding a big beach ball. This is first position. I want everybody to try it. Hold that big beach ball. Good. We're gonna open up to second position, okay? So feet are gonna open, arms are going to open. This is second position. My arms are not straight. They have a little bend to them, okay? And now we're going to go to third position. Does anybody know third? This one's trickier. You're going to put one foot in front just a little bit, and that same arm will round, okay? Third position with the feet, third position with the arms. Good. I see some of you doing it at home. Great job. Let's try fourth position. Does anybody know fourth position? This one's tricky. We're going to step that same foot out front. Step it in front, and you'll bring that same arm up to the ceiling. This is fourth position. This is also fourth position, having both arms rounded. Okay, now we're going to go to the trickiest position. Okay, so with your feet, you're gonna slide that foot all the way in. Heel to toe, heel to toe. That might be tricky for some of us, I totally understand, but we always want our toes facing out, away from the midline of your body. And arms, fifth position with the arms. Okay, can I see everybody at home try that? Fifth position, arms up. Good, I see some of you, amazing. So let's try the other side. So let's go back, a little review. First position, arms in first. Now who remembers second position, arms in second? Parents, do you remember? Feet out, arms out, second position. Yeah, I see some of you doing, it's awesome. Now let's take the other foot that you didn't do before. Put that one in front, and you're gonna round that arm, third position. Good, and now we're gonna go fourth position. Anybody remember? Boom, there's another arm for fourth. What is it? Boom, so both arms rounded. So this is fourth, this is also fourth. Last position, fifth position, slide that foot all the way in, both arms up. That is fifth position, okay? So now we know the five positions of ballet. That's really important to know. Maybe not at your age, maybe a little bit older, but still really good to be ahead of the curve and know those positions. Let's do some demi-pliés, okay? So we're gonna start with our feet zipped together. Let's put our hands on our hips. And we're gonna stand up really, really, really tall, and we're gonna bend our knees three times. Just follow along with me, okay? So we're gonna go plie, stretch, plie, stretch. One more plie, stretch. Big arms open. Again, plie, stretch. Squeeze your legs together. Last one. Big arms open. Let's open now to first position with our feet. Keep your hands on your hips. Here we go, same thing from first position. Demi-plie, stretch. You make that big diamond now. One more plie, and big arms. Woo! Last time, plie, stretch, plie, stretch. One more plie, stretch, and big arms. Good, back to the hips. All right, that was our demi-plie, so now our legs have a little more bounce to them. That's gonna get us ready to jump in a little bit. Let's continue with some tendus. All you have to do is follow along for this section. So I'm just gonna kind of keep doing some movements. I want you to follow along. So middle of your room, if you want something close by in case you need to hold something like a chair, for balance, you can totally do that. But let's come back to first position, and we're going to take those arms out to second position. With one foot, doesn't matter which one, I'm gonna start with my right leg, which is gonna look mirrored for you guys, but you can use whichever leg. We're gonna go tendu, close, again, tendu, close. One more, tendu, close, plie. With that same foot to the side, close, side, close, point your toes. Now demi-plie, plie. Now this is the hardest one, to the back, close, back, close. One more, and plie. Now we'll switch to the other side, front, in front of your nose, not out to the grocery store, just take it home. First position is your home. Plie. Good. We go to the side. Side. Point your foot to the side. Let me see it. Point those toes. One more. And plie. Now to the back. Behind you. This is the hard one. Last time. And plie. Let's take a releve for balance. Plie. Releve. Again. Plie. Heels up. One more. Uphold it. Test your balance. Test your balance. And come down. Good job. All right. Yeah, balance is so hard. Yeah, we don't want those feet to move around. We want to keep them nice and strong and still. Yeah, that's the hard part. Okay, let's move on. Let's do just one or two more things in the center of the room, then we're going to move across the floor, okay? Let's try some dégagés, and some piqués. If you don't know what a dégagé is, dégagé goes a little bit off the floor, a little bit off the floor. So tendu stays on the floor, dégagé goes off the floor. It means to disengage. Tendu means to stretch. Dégagé means to disengage. And we're gonna add some piqués in there, so you're gonna prick the floor. That's what piqué means. It means to prick. Do any of my 3 and 4 year olds, do you know what language ballet is in? Do we know what language it's in? If you know it, I want you to shout it out right now. Yeah, if you guessed French, you are correct. Yeah, ballet was started in the Italian and French courts. And so that is why, well, it started in Italy, and the King of France kind of took it. And he was like, I think that's cool. I want to steal it. So that is why ballet is in French. Yeah, it was created or made popular by King Louis XIV of France. Okay, so lots of history. You don't need that. First position. This song is too slow. I'm going to change to a quicker song, and we'll take some dégagé from first position. Arms out in second. So wait for me there. Here we go. Arms out. You're going to go front, close. Take a picture. Close. Now prick your toes. Prick and close. Same thing to the side. Close. Side. Hold it. Close. Piqués. Prick those toes. And close. Now we go back. Close. Back. Close. This is the hardest one. You just squeeze your tummies. Good. Now show me coupé. Hold it. Pop it a little higher. Back to coupé. Good. Now we're going to switch legs. Other side. Front. Close. Front. Close. Little pricks. Piqué. Piqué. To the side. Up. And try to hold it for a moment. Piqué. Good. And close. To the back. Last time. This is the hard one. Little piqués. Prick those toes. Try it. Last thing. We go coupé. Hold. Up to puppy. Hold. Coupé. And close back to first. All right, good job. I think that's enough of that. We're gonna move across the floor now. Now is a great time to grab a quick sip of water before we move back and forth across the floor. So if you need some water, grab it now. And then we're gonna move, move, move. Make sure you have a cleared out space wherever you are. Alrighty, once that is done, let's go to the far end of your room. Yeah, so you have lots of room to move across the floor. Okay, so I'm gonna start on this side so you can see everything that I'm doing. We're gonna rise up onto our tippy toes, and we're gonna move across the floor. Big, big butterfly arms, big arms. Good. Once you reach the end, you're going to turn around, bring your arms up to first position, and we're going to march. March. Lift your knees. You switch each side. Switch. Switch. March. March with me. We're going to do that same thing on tippy toes. Heel up. March. March. Stay up on your tippy toes. Good. I can see some of you doing awesome marches. Amazing. Good. I'm going to turn back around. Let's put right foot to the front. We're going to try skipping. Some of us have this coordination at this age. Some of us are still working on it. That's great. We're going to put our hands on our hips. And you're going to step hop to switch your legs. Each time. Step hop. Step hop. And up. And up. Good. Can I see some of you try? Step up. And up. Oh, I see the yellow dress. That is beautiful. Amazing. Yes, in the pink shirt. Amazing. I love it. So good. Let's try one more time, okay? With those skips. Here we go. Up and up. 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 Good. Yeah, skips are really good to know. And that might be in your recital dance. Whichever class you're in, you might end up doing skips, so they're good to know. Let's try some We're going to take our arm out to the side. What position is this? Second position. Good. We're going to go one foot to the front. We're going to switch our legs. Push. And push. Try to kick your legs up high. Push. Push. Woo. A few more. Try to go all the way across your floor with those high, high kicks. Yeah, I see you. I see you doing it. Amazing. Let's try a few more of those. Kick. 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 Good. Those are also called front bottom up. I want you to find a wall. Wherever you are, find a wall or something to hold on to, and we're going to try arabesque. Okay, so put two hands on your wall. Two hands on your wall, and you're going to lift one leg into arabesque. You want a straight leg with pointed toes. Let me see. Pointed toes. Good. Now switch to the other side. Arabesque. Hold it. Hold it. Pointed toes. Good. And hold. Arabesque should always have a nice straight leg with pointed toes. Good. All right. We're going to keep moving across the floor. So we're going to continue with chasse. Yeah. Chasse can go front. Or they can go side. Yeah, we're gonna start with front chasse. So go to the side of your room. We're gonna put one foot in front. I'm gonna start with my right leg. You can start whichever side you want. Make sure that foot stays in front the whole time. Arms up like you're holding that big beach ball. That foot stays in front. We go up, 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 up. Keep going. Same foot. Up, up. Let's try the other side, okay? Put your other foot in front. Point those toes. Turn this down. That foot will stay in front the whole time, okay? So here we go with that other foot. Shuffle, 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 shuffle. Keep going. Shuffle, shuffle. You can move around your room. Yeah, around the room. Right? So shuffle means to chase. So back leg is chasing the front leg. Now let's go sideways, okay? We're gonna take our arms out to the side. Point one foot to the side, and we're gonna go sideways. Down up, down up, down up. Keep going. Down up, down up, down up. Good. And now we're gonna switch legs. So put your other leg to the side. Here we go. Shuffle up, and up, and up, and up. Keep going with that same foot. Shuffle. Shuffle, shuffle, shuffle. Good. Now, can you say it with me? We don't want to say sashe. We want to say chasse. Chase. Chasse. Say it. Chasse. Chasse. Good. I can see some of you saying it. Amazing. Okay. Let's move on to some fun stuff. Yeah, that was all technical stuff. Now it's time to have some fun. We're going to go to a little freeze dance. So, this is where I'm gonna grab my pom-pom. You can grab anything you want. You don't need to grab anything, but it's always fun to have something in your hand to kind of shake or move around so that when you freeze, so does the pom-pom or whatever you're holding. So, the rules are very, very simple. When the music is on, what do you think we do? We dance. We dance when the music's on. When the music is off, what do you think we do? We freeze. So I want you to show me right now some of the positions you might freeze in, okay? This is not a good position to freeze in. We want big arms, big legs. Big arms, big legs. Yeah, that is a good, big, big pose. Yeah, the bigger the better, okay? So grab that pom-pom or whatever you have. And we're gonna do a little freeze dance. So let me find my music. Do, do, do. Here we go, freeze dance.
That is a game that's kind of neat.
This is where you get to dance however you want. Dance around the room. Whatever the music is telling you to do. Big arms, big legs, here we go. Big shape, hold it. And keep it. Keep dancing. Remember, you can dance with your arms. Maybe add some turns in there. Here we go. Tues. Maybe you can kick your legs up. You can also kick them to the back or to the side. We go three. Good. And keep going. You can dance backwards. You can dance forwards. You can go side to side. Many different directions. You can dance low or you can dance high. Good. Here we go. You can grab a flashlight here. So I'm gonna hold a wand and a flashlight, but you can pick one or the other, maybe just a flashlight, whatever you're feeling. Okay. I'm not gonna dim the lights all the way, otherwise you won't be able to see me. But I am gonna turn on some stars. Can you kind of see the stars? Not so much. Well, it's going. The disco ball is going. So I want you to imagine it's dark and there are stars out. I'm gonna find one song. And we are going to end ballet class with Under the Stars. Then we're going to switch to our tap shoes, okay? Last thing. Here we go. Creation Station. Here, finding our music. There we go. We're going to use a song from the new Trolls movie. Yeah, it hasn't come out yet, I don't think, but Trolls 2. It's with Justin Timberlake, super fun. Here we go.
Me, my mother, I take my
y'all want to see when I turn the lights back on. Big pose, please. All right, very nice. Now it's time to get into your tap shoes and get some water if you need some water, okay?
And hey guys, if you don't have tap shoes, that's okay. You can wear whatever shoes you have. And if you want, you can even tape a couple of quarters to the bottom of whatever shoes you have, and they'll make some noise and they won't hurt your parents' kitchen floor quite so much. So go ahead, take a quick break, get some water, get some shoes on to make some noise, and we'll keep going.
Yeah. Good. Now we're going to try walking on our feet. around the room. One more cup on those heels. Good. We're going to turn that to our tippy toes. Tippy toes. Tippy toes. Lift your heels up. Walk around your room. Okay. All right. We're going to try some heel toe walk. Heel toe. Heel toe. Heel toe. Yeah. I think we're going to be trying it. Yeah. Heel toe. Heel toe. That one's tricky. The next one is a little bit trickier. We're gonna wait for our music to restart and we're gonna try the opposite, which is your toe heel walk. So you start with your toe, then you drop your heel. Take the next step, toe heel. Okay, let's wait for our music. Here we go. Toe heel, toe heel. Try it, just walk around your room. Toe heel. Good. And next, we're going to try some little shuffles. Shuffle. Just move around your room. Little feet, little feet. Shuffle, shuffle, shuffle. Shuffle, shuffle, shuffle. Shuffle, shuffle, shuffle. Little feet. Good. Let's walk backwards. Look out for the things in your room. Little steps backwards. Little steps backwards. Good. All right. That is our tap warm up. And we're going to end in just a few minutes. I want to end class with a little obstacle course. You don't need anything for this. I'm going to put some things out so you can follow along with me. But you don't need to, you don't need any props for this, okay? I'm just gonna put a few things out as markers to show where I'm gonna do each of these steps. So the way we're gonna start is we're gonna start on the corner. Just go somewhere towards the wall. Yeah, so you have a lot of room. We're gonna start today with some TikToks, okay? We're gonna put our hands on our hips and we're gonna try some TikToks, okay? And then you're gonna switch to the other side. Some TikToks. After that, we're gonna take, to get to wherever the next place in the room is, wherever you wanna go, we're gonna go tippy toes to get to the next spot, okay? Then we're gonna just tap our toes. Just tap them. If, yeah, you would have a bell normally in class, but we're just gonna tap our toes, no bell. And then to get to the next spot in the room, wherever you want, we're gonna go on our heels. We're gonna go on our heels, and then we're gonna take a big hop. Big hop, boop. You can hop over something or you can just hop in your room. And then last thing we're gonna do is heel toe walks. Keep going around your room. Heel toe walks. And we're gonna finish with a big ta-da. Okay? So we're gonna try it all together, one group. You're gonna start on the side of the room and you're just gonna follow along with the steps that I do. So we're kind of putting some different steps together to make a little sequence, okay? So we start with our TikToks. Okay, then we switch feet, TikToks. Then we're gonna walk on our tippy toes to the next spot in the room. Gonna tap your toes. Then to get to the next spot in the room, we're gonna walk on our heels. Then what do? I can't remember. Oh, big hop. Whoop, big hop. To get to the very next spot in the room, wherever you wanna go, heel, toe, walks. Heel, toe, walks. And we finish with a big ta-da, and that will be the end of our class, okay? So last thing, let's all get up and try this. Parents too, everyone can try this one. Let's start edge of the room, okay? I'm gonna put on some music. All right, we start with our hands on our hips, and we start with some TikToks. Pick a foot. Other side, TikTok. Good. Now we're gonna try our tippy toes. Tippy toes. Next spot in the room. Tippy toes. Let's tap our toes. We go tap. You switch. You switch. Try a few. Good. Now we walk on our heels. Heels. Next spot in the room. Walk on your heels. Good. do our heel toe walks to finish up. Heel toe. Just walk around the row. And we're going to finish with a big ta-da. Everybody put your hands up. Big ta-da. Good job. You guys are done for the day. You're done with me today. Thank you so much for tuning in. There are plenty of other classes to watch. If there's anything else that you want to watch, we're going to be live all day. Many classes to choose from. I think you have six choices. Anyway, have a wonderful rest of your day. Stay safe and see you guys soon. Thank you. Is that Romy? Hi, Romy.
But Miss Linnea, we're about to do our dance move of the week, which is still going to be our ballet arms. However, grown-ups, you can't get your lollipops here, but you can get some treat from your grown-ups if you do the dance move. So follow along with Miss Linnea. We're going to do the dance move of the week, and then make sure your grown-ups give you a treat. Thank you for dancing. We appreciate you all.
We did it in class, but we're going to do it again, okay? See if you remember it. First position with your arms. Let me see.
Let's see it.
First position. Good. Who remembers second position? Second position with those arms. Yeah, you can do the feet too if you want. And third position. Who remembers third? Third. You bend one arm in. Good. And fourth, you take that same arm up. You can also bring that outside arm in. Those are both fourth position. Mm. Now, who remembers fifth position? Fifth position with your arms. Up here. That's right. Good job.
There you go, everybody. Hey, thank you for dancing. Make sure you get a treat from your parents, and we'll see you in class whenever you can make it. Have a great day.